Hello friends,
I am Professor Shraddha Sheke from KK Wagh Institute of Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about sensors. What is a sensor? Sensor is a device that converts a measurement into an electrical equivalent of that signal. It is a device that detects or measures a change in a physical quantity like light, heat, motion, moisture, pressure, etc. Transducer or a sensor is a device which is capable of converting the physical quantity into its proportional electrical quantity, such as voltage or current. Let us talk about classification of sensors. Sensor can be classified based on the different criteria like power requirement. Based on that, sensors are classified into two types: active sensors and passive sensors. Then other type of classification is based on the type of input or output. There are two types: analog sensor or the digital sensor. Then other type of classification is based on the parameter being measured, that is temperature or the resistance temperature detector, RTD, thermistor, thermocouple. These are the examples of temperature sensors. Then if you want to measure the parameter like force, weight, pressure, then strain gauges, load cell or pressure sensors can be used. Then motion or the position, for that LVDT and accelerometer are the sensors. Then optical, photodiode, light dependent resistor, and for the gas sensor. So broadly, sensors are classified into these types. Let us talk about active sensor and passive sensor. So what is active sensor? It is a transducer which generates the output in the form of voltage or the current without any external energy source, is known as active transducer. So in case of active transducer, there is no external energy source required. And in case of passive transducer means the transducer whose internal parameter like capacitance, resistance and inductance changes because of the input signal, and they require additional energy source, where the active transducer does not require the additional energy source. Working principle of the active transducer is they draws the energy from the measurement source. Measurement means the quantity which is to be measured. And in case of passive transducer or the passive sensors, they take a power from the external source which changes the physical properties of the transducer. Design. In case of active sensors or the active transducer, its design is simple, and in case of passive sensors, its design is complicated. Resolution of the active sensor is low. On the other hand, resolution of the active sensor is high. Output signal. In case of active signal, it produces from the signal to be measured. And in case of passive signal, output obtained by receiving the signal from the external power source. Some examples of active sensors are TACO generator, thermocouple, photovoltaic cell, etc. And passive sensors: thermistor, differential transformer, photomultiplier, tube and photovoltaic cell. Next classification is analog and the digital sensor. Analog sensor, it produces a continuous output signal or the voltage which is generally proportional to the quantity being measured. Physical quantities such as temperature, speed, pressure, strain, displacement, etc. are all analog quantities as they tend to be continuous in nature. Digital sensors. It produces a discrete digital output signal or the voltages that are digital representation of the quantity being measured. Digital sensor produces a binary output signal in the form of logic 1 or logic 0, that is on or off. Let us talk about the temperature sensors. So one of the example of the temperature sensor is the RTD, that is resistance temperature detector. There are two types of RTD, positive and the negative temperature coefficient. Resistance, what is basically positive temperature coefficient is called as PTC and negative temperature coefficient is called as NTC. What is a PTC? In which temperature and resistance are directly proportional to each other. That means if increase in the temperature is there, it will lead to the increase in the resistance. And if temperature decreases, resistance also decreases. On the other hand, NTC is a negative temperature coefficient in which temperature, resistance and the temperature are inversely proportional to each other. That means if temperature increases, its resistance will decrease. And if temperature decreases, its resistance will increase. It consists of the length of a fine wire made of the platinum, nickel or the copper, which is wrapped around a ceramic or a glass core. But the other constructions are also used. This sensor makes use of the temperature resistance relationship of the wire to measure the temperature. Platinum metal has stable temperature resistance relationship across the wide range of temperature. The mathematical relation between the temperature and the resistance is RT is equals to R0 in bracket 1 plus alpha in bracket T minus T0. In this case, RT and R0 are the resistance values at T degree Celsius and T0 degree Celsius temperature, and alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance at 0 degree Celsius. This graph shows the relation between temperature and resistance. On one axis, on x axis, there is a temperature in degree Celsius from 200, 400, 600 and so on. On the y axis, there is a resistance. If you observe, with increase in the temperature, resistance will also increase. Graph is drawn for three materials, platinum, copper and nickel. So all these graphs are for PTC, that is positive temperature coefficient. Observe the construction of this. The material resistance thermometer, this is a portion. Resistance thermometer, this portion is basically a portion which is to be, this is called as a sensor, or we can say this is sensing portion of a device. This is to be inserted in the liquid, or the it is kept in a contact of the device whose temperature is to be measured. Then connection leads are there, and insulation is also provided. On the right side, two leads are there which are connected to the circuit. Let us now discuss how that non-electrical signal, that is temperature, is converted into electrical signal, that is voltage.
Observe this circuit carefully.
This is called as Wheatstone bridge. See, up till now we have talked about how the temperature, change in the temperature is converted into the change in the resistance. There can be PTC, that is positive temperature coefficient. That means if temperature is increasing, the resistance of RTD will also increase. If temperature is decreasing, the resistance of RTD will also decrease. If we observe this device, we have to measure the voltage between these two terminals, positive and negative, denoted by DVM. And four resistors are connected. Right? Four resistors are there. Whenever values of these four resistors are same, then we can call this as a bridge is in a balanced condition. And the difference between these two terminal, which is denoted here DVM, that is positive and negative in this diagram. So whenever bridge is balanced, that means all the four resistors are having the same value. In that case, this difference is zero. But if any of the resistor changes its value, then there will be a difference in the voltage, and that voltage difference is given to the differential amplifier. And this is how changes in the resist temperature is converted into the changes in the resistor by RTD, and by using a Wheatstone bridge, that change in the resistance is converted into the change in the voltage. So you will observe this RTD, that is RG. This portion is to be inserted into the liquid whose temperature is to be measured, for example. So if temperature is increases, resistance of RTD, if we are using PTC, that is positive temperature coefficient, its resistance will also increase. All the three resistors in the given circuit are of the fixed values, so they cannot change their value. That means RTD will change based on the temperature, and the bridge is unbalanced, and we will get the potential difference, and that difference is applied to the amplifier. What are the advantages of RTD? It can be easily installed and replaced. It is available in the wide range. It can be used to measure the differential temperature. They are suitable for remote indications. Stability maintained over the long period of time. So it is stable. These are the advantages of RTD. Now talk about the disadvantages. The RTD require more complex measurement circuit. It is affected by shock and vibrations. So if you are using this in an environment, or it is if you are using this for the temperature, to measure the temperature of the device which is experiencing some vibrations, then the output of RTD is not proper. Bridge circuit is needed with the power supply. Slower response time than a thermocouple. This is one of the disadvantage of RTD. Then large bulb size, positivity of the self-heating, possibility of the self-heating, and sensitivity of the low. Sensitivity is low. So these are some disadvantages. Now, let us talk about what are the applications, where it is used. So RTD is used in the automotive to measure the engine temperature and oil level sensor. It is also used to measure the intake air temperature in an automotive sector. RTD is also used in the communication and the instrumentations for sensing the over and the temperature over the temperature of the amplifiers, transistor gain stabilizers, etc. In power electronics also, RTD can be used. Apart from this, it is used in computer, consumer electronics, food handling and processing, industrial electronics, medical electronics, military and aerospace. So this is about the RTD. In next video, we will discuss about the remaining two temperature sensors. Thank you.